Hello everybody and welcome back to another YouTube video. In this video I will be showcasing some recent advancements in conversational artificial intelligence.
Alright, so welcome back everybody. Hopefully you could understand that introduction from the computer here, but you can already assume that what I'm going to be doing in this video is just showing you some really cool examples of the current state of conversational artificial intelligence. Now, in case you don't know what that is, essentially conversational artificial intelligence is related to our communication with a computer. So for example, being able to say speak into the computer and having it translate that or understand that and put that into text, right? To give us a transcript of what we said. Being able to read, you know, paragraphs or human language and understand context, maybe answer questions based on that paragraph. And then of course this, which is text to speech. So taking some kind of text and then actually being able to pronunciate that text speak that back to us. So that is the example I just showed you here. Now, this video is kind of brought to you by NVIDIA. This is not a sponsored video. They haven't paid for this or anything like that, but they sent me a bunch of resources related to what they're currently working on. Well, I thought it was cool and I wanted to make a video about it. Now, if you guys think that's cool as well, you like this kind of keeping up with the current trends and understanding what, you know, huge AI companies like NVIDIA are doing, they're actually hosting a GPU technology conference, the GTC. I'm going to be attending this. It's from October 5th to 9th, so a few days from this video when it's being uploaded or released or whatever. And they've actually given me 3 free passes to give away to you guys. So usually this is paid. I don't know how much it costs, but if you leave a comment down below, just leave like your name or some way for me to contact you, essentially like an email address or a Twitter or an Instagram. I'll pick a few of you from the comment section and I'll give you guys these passes. And well, you can come and attend the workshops and the conference and kind of see what NVIDIA is working on related to conversational AI, their GPU technology, and a bunch of other really cool stuff. So that being said, let's dive in and let me show you some examples and talk about kind of how us as developers can access this really cool conversational AI technology. So NVIDIA is working on this library or toolkit, whatever you want to call it, which is called NeMo. Now, NeMo, I believe it says here, stands for neural modules. And essentially a neural module is a part of the conversational AI pipeline. So imagine like when you're creating some kind of, you know, conversational AI, you're going to have different stages to that. You're going to have to understand text. You're going to have to run that through a model. Maybe you have to pre-process it. And then you're going to have to analyze that output and do all these other things. Essentially, what NeMo does is give you access to all of these individual modules, which are like stages in that pipeline that you can combine together, change, modify, tweak, or even just use out of the box without making any modifications to create your own conversational AI. Now, it's very much in the early stages right now. There's definitely a few like glitches and bugs with it, or at least things that it's just not the easiest to set up. But I've been working with NVIDIA for, you know, a week or so, and I've got a bunch of examples set up that I want to show you. These aren't crazy. I'm no expert. I don't completely understand how all of these things work, but I know some of you will and you guys will be interested in that. So I wanted to just kind of showcase it to you. So the first thing I have here to talk to you about is simply automatic speech recognition. So this is allowing us to speak into the computer and then have the computer actually take what we say and will translate that into, you know, natural human language, give us a transcript of what's being said. Now, I haven't been able to get this example to work just based on my lack of knowledge with it for my own voice, but they have a cool example here that I can show you that actually takes some like pre-recorded scripts and will analyze them, give you like a spectrogram of it, and then actually tell you exactly what it said. All right, so I've got the example up and running and I will kind of show you how it works. So let me just zoom in a little bit so you guys can read this. So obviously just installing like a bunch of dependencies at the top. This is downloading all of the test and like training files that we can use for this model, which you'll see in a second. And this is just one of the training examples that I'll play now so you can hear what this text sounds like or what this speech sounds like. And then I'll show you the translation for it from this model.
G-L-E-N-N.
All right, so obviously clearly articulated. I'll play it one more time.
G-L-E-N-N.
And now what I'm going to do is kind of show you, first of all, the spectrogram for this, or the waveform, sorry, not the spectrogram, that's coming next. You can see that we have the G, we have the L, we have the E, and then two N's, which look fairly similar, as they should, because they are, you know, the same sound. So we have Glenn, that's what is being said. And essentially, I'm just going to show you how easy it is to take this audio file, so this WAV file, and use this module from Nemo to translate this or get a transcript for it. So first of all, this is an example of what we call the audio spectrogram. Now, I'm not a physics major, so I'm not going to really explain how any of this works. I feel like I'm going to butcher that. But you can kind of see the frequencies that are appearing in this sound. So this is just showing you kind of the underlying way that this model would go about actually listening to this specific audio sound and then coming up with what it actually is. So you can see that's a spectrogram, and then this is what's known as the MEL spectrogram. So this is just a transformation to make this more like how humans would actually hear these sounds. Again, I'm not going to explain much about that, but it's just showing you the plot of that audio file that I played, which was GLENN. You can see the spaces, and then clearly all of the different characters with the two N's looking pretty similar. Anyways, then what I do here is I simply import the Nemo package. So again, neural modules. I import the ASR, which is automatic speech recognition, and then I just create a model from a pre-trained model. So I don't have to train this. I don't have to do anything specifically here. I can just load in all of the pre-trained weights, biases, settings, all of that from the QuartzNet 15x5 base English. I believe that's what that stands for with the EN. So I think they do have other languages in here as well. And then all I have to do is simply supply a file or multiple file names. And then I can just use the .transcribe method on this model, and it will give me the transcription for this audio file. So if I run this, we can see that this audio file that I had played for you was recognized as Glenn. Now, of course, you can think that this is cheating just because, this is NVIDIA's example that they gave me, but I can assure you that this does work. And I just want to show you how simple it actually is to use, speech to text. And this works pretty well. There's other things that work differently. Speech to text, that's not really that impressive of a thing. We have dictation and all these other things on our phone that can do this, but this works extremely fast. You can pass audio files in. And well, this is kind of the first toy example that I wanted to show you. Now, the next one that I want to show you is way cooler in my opinion. And this is like a question answering bot, if that makes any sense. So essentially what this example does is it takes some kind of context. So like some paragraph, for example, imagine like a paragraph out of a textbook or something like that. And then you can ask questions about that piece of text and it will actually give you back the answer. So of course you need to train this model, right? There's a lot of examples that you have to go through, a lot of training that has to be done to make this work properly. But once you have a trained model, it's good enough to be able to understand the context of a paragraph and actually answer questions for you. So this is, again, is a notebook. I'll link all these notebooks as well as the last one, which was this one right here that goes through like the full explanations of how all of this stuff works in the description. But I wanna show you how this one works. Let me reconnect and I'll get it all set up. All right, so the model is now trained. It's gonna be hard for me to illustrate exactly what this is doing and how this works, but if you understand this, it's really cool. So just have a look here. There's a file that is the test file. So the test file essentially is the data that we tested this model on. So just to see how well it performed to get some kind of accuracy score, right? And then we had a prediction file, which essentially is gonna be the predictions that this model had for some given text. So just to refresh everyone, what happens is we have this context. Some kind of paragraph, some kind of string of text, whatever it may be. And the point of this model is to be able to read that paragraph and answer questions relating to it. So if we give it some kind of question based on that text, it should not only understand the question, but it should understand the text and it should be able to extract the answer from that text. Now, of course, the answer that we're going to get is going to be like a piece of text from the original context. So it's not smart enough to come up with its own answer based on the text. It needs to use part of the text, but it can at least locate that answer, which is pretty cool. So if we have a look here, I'm just going to print out the context and some examples of answers. So this is the test file and the context we have is this. Now I'm not going to read this, but you get the point. It's talking about Super Bowl 50. It's saying who won, what year it was happening, the colors, all this kind of stuff. It's all contained in this. And the model will be given this as some input. It will also be given a list of questions and then it will output answers. Now, what we're looking at here is the answers that we fed into the model. So we essentially said that, okay, these are the valid answers for each of these questions. Sometimes there's more than one valid answer. And notice that since we had three answers for each, sometimes we duplicated them just to say, yep, like this, the correct answer is only found in this place, but we just need to have three for each of them to stay consistent. But if you get the point, this is saying, okay, like question, which I think is right here. Okay, so which NFL team represented the AFC at Super Bowl 50? And then says, okay, the answers for that are this. And one of the answers is Carolina Panthers, right? And then, you know, we keep going and there's more questions and there's more answers. And technically there could be more than one answer for some of these questions, right? If they're too vague or whatever it may be. So this is the actual answers that we fed in as our testing data. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run and I have like some nicely formatted output here to show you what the model actually predicted for some questions that we asked based on this text. So if I run this, we can see this was the text again, and then the questions are whatever is before the colon. So which NFL team represented the AFC at Super Bowl 50? And then we get Denver Broncos, right? That is the answer that our model came up with. I promise you I'm not cheating. This was actually the prediction from the model. And then we get which NFL team represented the NFC at Super Bowl 50? And then it says Denver Broncos defeated the National Football Conference NFC champion Carolina Panthers. So clearly it's just taking that from the text, but still pretty cool that it can figure that out. And then where did Super Bowl 50 take place? Santa Clara, California. I've never heard of this actually, so maybe I'm mispronouncing that. And then which NFL team won Super Bowl 50? Denver Broncos. And what color was used to emphasize the 50th anniversary of the Super Bowl? That answer is gold. Now, if you go in here, again, I'm not going to read it, you'll find that those answers are correct, but that's what this model can do. So this is an example of natural language processing. And personally, I think this is really cool that we can actually ask questions to an AI. They don't need to be hard coded. It doesn't have to have seen them before, and it can read through text and actually extract the answer for us. So anyways, that's enough for this example. Hopefully you find that as cool as I do. And now we'll move on to the last one, which is text-to-speech, which you've kind of already seen. All right, so now we're looking at TTS inference, which is text-to-speech inference. I'll just quickly read this first section here, or I'll summarize it for us, I guess. Essentially, what this is going to do is it's going to take some text, so some text that we type in, it's going to generate a spectrogram for that text, and then it's going to use that spectrogram to generate an audio file that's actually pronouncing it. So you can see that we have kind of five different parameters here that we can choose from. So we can use two different main MEL spectrogram generators, so the Tacotron 2 or the Glow TTS. And then from that spectrogram, we can use one of these three audio generators to generate something in kind of like a different voice. So I'll show you examples of, well, not all of them, but some of them, and you'll see kind of how they work and how they sound different. All right, so the first step here is to pick our spectrogram generator. So I'm going to pick a Tacotron 2, and then we need to pick an audio generator. I'll just go with Waveglow, and then I'll show you some of the other ones after, and you can hear the difference between them. So we have Waveglow. I'm going to run this. This will take a second, then I'll be back with the next cell. All right, so I've ran all that, and then I ran this infer function definition. Now what I'm going to do is simply just type in what text I want the model to say. So in this case, let's just say this is just a test to see how good this sounds. All right, so then I will hit enter, and then all I'll do is wait a second for this to, I guess, go through the infer. Now I can run this. It's going to generate an audio file, and let's run it.
This is just a test to see how good this sounds.
So in my opinion, that sounds pretty good. Like, that's pretty good for a robot voice and a pretty immediate audio file generation. So let's do something else. Let's just say another test here. Is it good with other words and sounds? ? And let's see how it laughs if I give it a ha ha ha. All right, so enter and wait for this guy to run. Run this.
Another test here. Is it good with other words and sounds? Ha ha ha.
Okay, so the laugh is interesting, but you get the point. It actually sounds pretty good, and this is like not that robotic of a voice compared to some other things that I've heard. So I'm going to run this again. I'll just pick a different setting this time for here, and then we'll see how that sounds. Okay, so I'm going with Glow TTS, and then let's just see what Griffin underscore Lim sounds like. All right, so I'm going to try it now. So now let's see what this voice sounds like, and if it is any, if I could spell any correctly, different. All right, enter, and let's run this, and let's see what it sounds like.
Now let's see what this voice sounds like, and if it is any different.
All right, so clearly this is a lot different. This sounds kind of like an alien almost, but that gives you the point that when we mess around with the different spectrogram generators, and the audio generators, the different combinations of those two are going to result in different sounds. So I'll let you guys play around with this. Again, I'll leave all the resources for this in the description. You should be able to just like copy all the stuff in these notebooks into a Google Collaboratory notebook, and then you can just run all of the cells like I've done here. That's exactly what I did. And you can kind of mess around with this and see how it works. But I think with that, I'm going to leave the video here. So again, this is kind of a random video, but I just figured it was a good idea. NVIDIA gave me some free passes for the GPU technology conference, which I figured I could give away to you guys. And I think this stuff is kind of cool. I've been playing around with it. I'm trying to see if I can make anything using this technology. I will say that it doesn't work extremely well on Windows. That's why it's better to just run it in Google Collaboratory. But if you have a Linux machine, you can definitely set this up on your local computer and probably create some pretty decent conversational AI, or at least integrate this into some kind of project. So anyways, if you guys enjoyed, make sure you leave a like, subscribe to the channel. And of course, if you want to win the NVIDIA GTC free pass, then leave a comment down below in the comment section with some way that I can contact you, like a Twitter handle, Instagram, something like that, so I can reach out.